제85회 가보고 싶어요.
And welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host, Lisa Kelly. And have I ever showed you this wonderful little table? This is a Korean traditional little table, and we can hide our little goodies in here. Not only does it look pretty, but it's very useful. Here's my co-host.
It comes in handy, these little desks here. Welcome to LSK. I am your Hunjang Kim Young. And guess what? We learned how to say, where do you want to go? Or what do you want to do? Let's go somewhere. Let's try this right now. We're going to find out which and what kind of.
안녕하세요. I'm Blake and I am the student. So you're basically learning right along with me so we can pass or fail together.
Today's lesson may sound a little long, but don't worry. They're very easy and easy to master. So take a listen first.
네, 아리랑 TV 시청자 여러분 안녕하세요. 가수 김태호입니다. 제가 오늘 여러분들에게 가르쳐드릴 문장은요. 거기 어때? 라고 물어봤을 때 대답하는 문장입니다. 바로 이렇게 대답하면 됩니다. 좋아요? 가보고 싶어요.
어느 산에 갈 거예요?
설악산 어때요?
좋아요. 가보고 싶어요.
어느 산에 갈 거예요? Now the person being invited is asking, now which mountain are we going to? There are lots of mountains in Korea. It's a very mountainous landscape, and there's lots of beautiful mountains to visit. So which one? This word here, 어느, is which. Which one? So I stole Blake's cups here earlier.
Yes, you did.
어느 cup? Which cup, right? Finger, 손가락, 어느 손가락, which finger? Like this, so you can say 어느 to mean which one. 산, remember it meant mountain. 산에, 어느 산에, 가다 means to go. And then we're asking a question, 갈 거예요? 어느 산에 갈 거예요? Which mountain will we go to? 어느 산에 갈 거예요?
어느 산에 갈 거예요?
Very good. 설악산 first. This is one of the most famous mountains in Korea. 설악산.
설악산.
Good. 설악산 어때요? We're asking, what do you think of 설악산? Since we asked 어느 산, right? So 설악산 어때요? What do you think of 설악산? Now you can just use 어때요 by itself or with other questions. What do you think of my outfit today? 어때요? 어때요? Is it okay? 어때요? 좋아요?
뭐 먹을까요? Right? You said that, and then you might suggest something. Let's say I'm suggesting 라면. 라면 어때요? Let's say I'm suggesting 비빔밥. 비빔밥 어때요?
What do you think of that?
Okay. How about 비빔밥?
Yeah. Yeah. What if you're suggesting 갈비?
갈비 어때요?
With your clothes, with your hair, with the movies, anything around you. 어때요? Try that. 어때요?
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 All right, and we responded, did you want to go to 설악산? Yes, I did. So we say 좋아요, and we've learned this before. Let's say it together. 좋아요. Okay, good.
좋아요.
Sounds good. Okay, I want to do it. 가보고 싶어요. 가다 is to go, so I want to go there and try it out. I want to experiment it. I want to see what 설악산 is all about. So we say 좋아요.
좋아요.
Okay, 가보고 싶어요.
가보고 싶어요.
And when you end the sentence with 고 싶다, right? We're wanting something, we're craving something, right? Oh, I'm so hungry. I want to taste that. 먹고 싶어요. Oh, I so want to go and see that. 보고 싶어요, right? And here we want to go and try it out. 가보고 싶어요.
가보고 싶어요.
Right.
가보고 싶어요. I want to go and experience that. I want to go. I've never been there before. 가보고 싶어요. I want to go there and experience that. And there's also 해보고 싶어요. It's like bungee jumping, right? You're not going to go bungee jump, but you're going to go try it out. 해보고 싶다. I want to go and try and experience this. 해보고 싶어요.
The difference between the two is 가보고 싶어요 is more of the motion of going there, whereas 해보고 싶다 is actually doing it with your hands, such as you said, bungee jumping, scuba diving, skiing, all of this. We want to do it, right? 해보고 싶다.
Yeah.
해보고 싶다. It's my first time in Korea, and I'd like to, you know, see some sights, eat some delicious food, and just have some fun.
You like mountainous regions? Mountains?
Yeah.
Very beautiful in 설악산 Mountain. 설악산 어때요?
좋아요. 가보고 싶어요.
Do you like 불고기? 불고기 어때요?
좋아요. 먹어보고 싶어요.
Oh, it's very good. You'll love it.
What? So cool? My shirt!
Well, you have a shirt that says up, which is front in Korean.
Yeah, but look at the back! Ta-da!
In the back, it says 뒤.
Uh-huh. Yeah, isn't that
is
cool?
Back in Korean. Up, 뒤. Up, 뒤.
Yeah.
And there's no 옆, which is side.
Oh, well, next time.
Okay, well, what's with this shirt? What's the big deal?
All around, not just Korea, but around the world, is putting Korean lettering on your clothes and accessories. It's kind of like I remember when I was little, I used to think that all those Chinese characters, even though I didn't know how to read them, were so cool. Now, it's Korea's turn to be all over the world, all over your clothes. You know, there was a fashion show recently in Europe where a Korean designer went and put his designs in Korean lettering all over his words.
Really?
It was all the rave.
Wow, you know, that just reminds me, there was a rock band that was on a music cable TV channel a little while back, and there was this guy, the guitarist was wearing something, a shirt that said something, something, 교회.
Church!
교회, Korean which church. Is church, and it was
all
in
right,
Korean.
All right, Korea power!
Here's the first question on the test, on today's test. You and a friend decide that you guys want to go hiking up in the mountains, and you want to suggest a mountain, a certain mountain called 설악산 to him. How would you say that in Korean?
I would say 설악산 어때요?
Very good, 설악산 어때요? And number two, listen to my question, which I'm going to ask in Korean, and tell me, answer me by saying that yes, you like it and you want to go there. 남산 어때요?
좋아요. 가보고 싶어요.
Now, our main focus today was on several points, but remember this one, 어느 versus 무슨. 어느 is which one, whereas 무슨 is what kind of, what type of, what genre. Now, back to our sentence, 어느 산에 갈 거예요? Which mountain are you going to go to? 설악산 어때요? Hey, what about 설악산? 어때요 is that form where you're asking, what do you think of something? And 좋아요, 가보고 싶어요. 좋아요, I like it. 가보고 싶어요. I really want to go there. You know, not only do you have to feed your brain, but you have to feed your soul if you're going to continue studying. So I say we go and eat. 갈비 어때요? How about 갈비, huh?
비빔밥 어때요?
No. 냉면 어때요?
I had 냉면 yesterday. No.
All right, we're going to settle this and you guys go and stay some more, okay? Bye-bye. No!